Hi, everybody, and welcome back to the Coderoom. Okay, so in previous episodes, we talked about CSS and what CSS is all about, and even what the CSS code looks like, okay? Now, today, we're going to teach you the first way that you can actually incorporate that CSS code into your HTML document so you can actually style your HTML tags and elements, okay? So just to recap quickly, we showed you that CSS code looks like this, okay? It's all about a property, colon, and then its value. Okay, so if you want to set the color to blue, you do color, colon, blue. And then you separate multiple property listings with a semicolon, okay? Now, the question is, how do we put this into the document, okay? So the first way we're going to teach you is called inline CSS. In other words, we're going to put the CSS directly in line with the HTML tag that we want to apply it to, okay? So let's see what that looks like. All right, so here we got our code, and we have our website here, and we have movies, okay? So let's find that H1 tag. Okay, so here's our code here, and we have that H1 tag right here, okay? Now, if you want to apply some CSS style code to that specific H1 tag, you can do it inline, and this is how you do it. You add a style attribute, okay? So just like how links have an href attribute, just like how images have a source attribute, let's add a style attribute to the H1, okay? So inside the opening tag, but before the greater than sign, you put style, and this is just like any other attribute, so equals and quotation, quotation, okay? So that sets up that you're gonna put some CSS code in there, all right? Style equals quotation, quotation. Now your CSS code itself goes inside the quotations, okay? So let's apply color blue, okay? So we just type color, colon, blue, and then end it with a semicolon. Okay, oh, it's good practice to end it with a semicolon, even if you don't have multiple properties, okay? So let's save that, go back to our browser, refresh, and there you go. Our header is blue. So it's just that easy. You add a style attribute to the opening tag, and then you specify your CSS there. So now let's say we want to specify a second property. Okay, now because this is inline, you can put it right next to that semicolon, okay? So after color blue, we're going to do font family colon. And in this case, we're going to use single quotations because we're using double quotations for the outer quotations. And this way, HTML doesn't get confused. And we'll put Arial. Save that. Go back here. Refresh. And there you go. You see movies is now the Arial font. And then the last thing I want to do is make it a little bit bigger. So let's put a semicolon. Font size, colon, 20, let's do 30-point font. Save that, refresh, and then you see it's bigger there. Okay? So we have style, color blue, font family Arial, font size 30, and we got that there. Okay? So let's apply this to all of our headers, okay? So under video games, let's add a style tag to that. We'll do color blue, font family Arial, and then font size 30 points. So save that. Whoops. Okay, refresh this. And there we go, video games is updated. I forgot TV here, let's do the same thing for TV. Blue, font family Arial, font size 30 points. And there, TV's done too, okay? And links and pricing and favorite foods and all these, let's just copy and paste them to save some time. So I'll copy the style attribute that I have here and I'll apply it to links, pricing, my favorite foods, and steps to fly a drone, okay? Just copy and pasting that code. And now all my headers look the same. So that's how you incorporate the CSS code inline. Let's try it with a couple others. So let's try the paragraph text, okay? So let's say the paragraph text, we want that to be Arial as well, and maybe we'll change the color to gray, okay? So let's go to our paragraph text here. We'll add a style tag. We'll do the color is gray, and we'll do the font family Arial as well. Okay, save that, refresh. And there you go, okay? And again, I want all my paragraphs to look the same, so I'm just gonna copy and paste that style into all my paragraphs here. Copy and paste, copy and paste. There we go. Okay. And let's do one last one. Let's work with the links. Let's add some inline CSS styling to the links. Okay. So if I go down here and I look at the links, okay, I'm going to keep them that font, but I want to change the color of these links. Okay. Now, the interesting thing here is if you look at a link, we actually already have an href attribute. So how do you add a style attribute when there's already an attribute there? Well, it's pretty simple. This is the first time we've encountered multiple attributes. As long as they're separated by spaces, you're good to go. Okay, so we have an href attribute here. So all we have to do is just hit a space and add a style attribute. Okay, and this applies to any attributes that you add to any HTML tags. They just have to be separated by spaces, and it doesn't even matter what order they appear in. Okay, you could have put style at the front or after href. It's totally up to you. All right, so the style of this link, we're going to put color green. Save that. Refresh it. Okay, there we go. We got the green link. And I'm going to do the same thing to all of my links here. So style, color, green. Style, color, green. Whoops. And style, color, green. Save that. Refresh it. And there we go. All our links are green now. All our headers are blue and big text. And all our paragraph text is gray. Okay, so hopefully now you understand how to put CSS code in line with your HTML tags. Okay, you just added that as a style attribute to your HTML tag, and you'll be good to go. All right, that's it for this episode. We'll see you guys in the next one.